Hi guys, CodeTutor here and my name is Anil Deshpande.
In the previous video, you have seen the implementation of query method. By now, it would have become very clear to you that you have a content provider which will be having the implementation of the methods that you need to override, and it actually invokes the method that is there in the DB adapter. So we will be requesting a method that is there in the DB adapter which will actually do query operation, and it will return the cursor, and query will in turn return that cursor to the external entities that might be using this particular method. So we will be seeing a similar methodology in all of the remaining methods. So let's get started with the insert method. Insert will basically insert a value into the database. So you will have to call a method that is there in the DB adapter, which will actually do the insertion, and it will return a URI. As you are already aware, a typical URI contains content, authority, and the path. After you insert a particular tuple into the database, a new ID for that particular tuple will be generated. It could be 1, 10, or 20, depending upon whatever the state of your database is. So whatever the ID that is returned after successful insertion, that needs to be appended to the URI string, and that is what needs to be returned from the insertion method. If you are wondering how the method arguments of the insert would look like, it would be two arguments. First one is URI. The second is the content values. As you are aware, the content values is nothing but the key value pair containing the column and the value that you want to insert into the database. From the implementation perspective, you will basically create a content values instance and then add a column name and value that you want to insert in that particular column name using content values dot put method. Now coming to the next method, that is delete. Once again, you would be invoking a method that is there in the DB adapter, which will be doing the actual delete operation. It will return int. The int value stands for the number of rows that got deleted when you executed this operation. The content provider's delete method arguments would be URI, string where clause, and array of strings. The where clause is a comparator function that you would be using, and array of strings is substitution values that you would be doing. So from the implementation perspective, where would be something like underscore ID equals to question mark or actual value, and the runtime substitution would be an array of string containing the values where the question mark would be replaced with a particular value. And in the same way, in the case of update method, there will be a method in the DB adapter which will return an integer value, and integer value here basically stands for number of rows that got affected when you executed the update method. The argument of the update method would be like URI. The second argument would be content values, which you already know is a key value pair of column and new value that you want to update. And the next two remaining arguments, where and string array, will complete the where clause, because when you want to update, you want to update a particular values which satisfy a particular condition. So enough of theory. Next would be to have a look at the code and see how it works. I think by now you would be familiar with the project that we have been discussing. So this is the content provider, and in this particular content provider, these are the methods that we have implemented: insert, update, and delete. So let us see what happens in case of insert. If you observe, the arguments are URI and content values. You will observe that this method actually throws also an exception called as unsupported operation exception. The idea is, if the URI that is passed doesn't match, I want to throw this particular unsupported operation exception. It is an optional one, but it is a good practice to provide this particular exception whenever you are working with content providers, because it helps you to manage the exceptional cases. Now coming back, I have written another private method, insert to do. This particular private method actually calls the insert method that is defined in the to do list DB adapter. It returns a long value, and this particular long value is finally appended. And another important concept here is, I am invoking a method called as getContext getContentResolver dot notify change. If you are using, say, loader, then as soon as the dataset changes, the loader will automatically be restarted. New values would be queried from the content provider. So that is the whole idea of invoking this particular method. The next method is delete. Once again, as you you can see, the first argument is URI, the second argument is where clause, and the third argument is the value substitution. And once again, we are using unsupported operation exception, because if developer doesn't pass the appropriate URI or appropriate values, we will be throwing a unsupported operation exception. And then if the URI match happens, I am invoking the delete method. As you can see here, the default value of the delete count is -1, because as per the documentation, if the delete method returns -1, that means the deletion failed. That is what we will be returning if this particular statement fails to do the delete operation. There is another method, delete, and this delete method invokes the DB adapter's delete method. The next method is update. The first argument is URI, second argument is content values, which will be containing the column and the values that you want to add into that particular column, where clause, and substitution of the where values. And once again, if the update operation fails, this is the value that we will be returning. Do the URI matching, we invoke the method called as update, which is a private method. We pass the content values, where clause values, and the update method is once again another private method, which actually invokes update method of the to-do list DB adapter. And that is how you complete the implementation of all these methods, that is insert, update, delete, and we have already seen the query method. The only method that is left is get type. We will discuss this and few more finer aspects, and then we will move on to using this particular content provider in a third-party app in the next video. Stay tuned. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.